School Freeware's free Pascal program tutorials. Tutorial 28, running external programs. Tutorial 28's example is Windows only. However, the T process can be used on Mac and Linux. The T process is used to run programs and batch scripts. And process must be added to the uses for T process to work. The T process syntax is as follows. We'll have a variable of tprocess. In this particular case, we have runProgram. Once the variable is created, runProgram becomes the tprocess.create, in this particular case, with nil being passed. We'll then have runProgram.commandLine, in which we will load the program location. The program location is a string. Then we'll execute. And finally, when we're done, we'll free. This is the batch file that we'll use within this tutorial. The batch file is c:test.bat, and the code is as follows. The code used within this tutorial can be downloaded at schoolfreeware.com. A new program has been created. Normally, we would put the code used to make the program stop within the program. However, is not necessary with this particular type of program. So I'm going to start off by going into uses and loading process. From there, I'll make a variable called run program. Run program will be a T process. I'll go into the main program and set run program to T process. Dot create. I'll then pass nil. I'll run program dot command line. And I'll load in the location of the program that I wish to run. In this particular case, it'll be the calculator. So calc.exe. Run program dot execute. And finally, run program. Dot free. Okay, I'll go ahead and run, and the calculator should pop up there on the screen. Our program ran, and here's the calculator. I'll put another example. We'll try Internet Explorer. I'll run program dot command line. We'll set the command line to the location of Internet Explorer. And I'll have Internet Explorer go to the School Freeware website. Run program. Dot execute. And I'll go ahead and run. There's the calculator. And Internet Explorer pops up. Okay, I'll close down Internet Explorer and the calculator. For the last example, we'll run the batch file, runprogram.commandLine. The batch file is located on the C drive, and the name is test.bat. I'll run program.execute. And for this example to work, the batch file that was shown earlier in the tutorial must be loaded. Okay, I'll go ahead and run now. The calculator pops up. Internet Explorer is going to the School Freeware website, and here is the batch file. The batch file runs MS Paint. I'll close down MS Paint. Shows the time, and then stops.